Children, see these questions. Draw the graph of the following equations. X is equal to 2, x is equal to minus 2, minus 2, x is equal to 3, x is equal to minus 3. Now, let us see. In the last class, I said, how can we represent a one variable equation on number line? And how can we convert a one variable equation into two variable? Let us see now. Now we have taken this problem, x is equal to 2. This, you know, it is a one variable equation. Here x is only the one variable. Now we have to represent this on the number line. Means it comes here. When we plot this point, this is the place where x is equal to 2 is on the number line. Now let us convert this into two variable equations. To convert this into two variable, we will write x as it is and z, we'll write y as 0 into y is equal to 2. Here we are multiplying a number with 0, means it is equals to 0. Here we are writing 0 into y, means it is 0 only, but it is a representation of two variable equation. Okay, one variable equation can be represented in this way. Now let us make y as independent and we'll give the values to y so that we'll get the values for x, and let us represent this on the graph paper. Okay children, now I'm making y as independent, so I'm taking the values 1, x is equal to, y is equal to 1. If I place y is equal to 1 here, it is 0 is multiplied by y, that is here 0 is multiplied by 1, that gives you 0. So here you will get the value for x as 2. In the same way, if I give the value of 2 here, when I put in the place of y 2, this is 0 into 2. 0 into 2 is nothing but 0. So we will get the value for x as 2 only. Okay. So let us take one more value, 3. If I put 3 here, this is again 0 into 3. So the value will become 0. So x is equal to 2. Again you have got the same value. Now we will put the minus values. Here it is minus 1. If I put here minus 1, 0 is multiplied by minus 1 will give you 0. So this term becomes 0. So you will get again 2. Same way for minus 2. If I put minus 2 here, 0 is multiplied by minus 2 and the term becomes 0. So x is equal to again 2. If you observe all these things, you are getting the same values for x when you change the values for, when you have given the different values for y, but you are getting the same values for x. Now let us represent this on the graph. Now here we have the graph. So we have to plot these points x comma y as 2 comma 1. Here it is 2 comma 2. Here 2 comma 3. It is 2 comma minus 1. And here 2 comma minus 2. And this one minus 2. 2 comma minus 3. Let us represent these values on the graph paper. Okay, the first point, let us name it as A, B, C, D, E, F. So the first point A is 2 comma 1. So we can plot this point here. This on x axis it is 2. So this is like this. On y axis it is here. So the intersecting point of this is 2 comma 1. Now the second, this is the point A. Okay, this is the point A. Now let us write second point B, 2 comma 2. If you observe this, here 2, on x axis it is 2, on y axis it is 2 here. So this is the point B, 2 comma 2. And this one 2 comma 3. 2 comma 3, here the point 2 comma 3. This is the point C. Now the other point, D point, is 2 comma minus 1. So we have to See the downwards. So this is the point. This is 2 and this is minus 1. The intersecting point is D, 2 comma minus 1. So the x coordinate is 2, y coordinate is minus 2. So y coordinate we are seeing here, it is minus 2. So this is the point E, 2 comma minus 2. And the last point F, 2 comma minus 3 will come here. This is 2 and this is minus 3. So the point F comes here, 2 comma minus 3. 2 comma minus 3. If we join all these points, if you observe this, all these points are in a straight line. Okay? These are the points A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay. Now we have plotted all the points. If you observe these points are all in a line which is 2 units away from y-axis. This is y-axis and this is x-axis. Okay, now we have drawn the graph for x is equal to 2. We have got a line which is parallel to y-axis, 2 units away from y-axis. Is that clear, children? Now let us draw one more. First let us discuss once again this. We have plotted x is equal to 2 on the graph paper and observed that it is a straight line which is parallel to y-axis. X is equal to 2. When we plotted this on the graph paper, we have got a line, straight line, which is parallel to x-axis because it is equidistant, 2 meters away from y. Everywhere it is 2 meters away from y-axis. So it is a line parallel to y-axis, which is 2 meters away from the y-axis. Every point is 2 meters away from the y-axis. Okay, now let us see one more.